Test 1, 2, 3. Okay, record. Hi guys, welcome to another Blender tutorial. If you're a new subscriber, I upload Blender tutorials. 100 subscribers, PewDiePie, I'm gonna catch you. So basically I'm gonna show you some procedural grass shader. I stole some of those stuff, but whatever. No one cares, I don't care. So basically I'm gonna show you the nodes, but first just add a plane, subdivide plane by 100 times. Change right here the engine to the cycles, turn the values down if you have bullshit PC. Go to the materials tab, add new material, and on the settings, change to displays and bump only, or maybe displays only. And I'm gonna share with the notes. You can search those notes by Shift A. So basically, we're gonna need textures coordinate. I'm gonna make this bigger. So textures coordinate from UV. Connect to the mix RGB right here and just play around. If I'm gonna play around on this mix RGB, I have effect on this noise texture, yes, right here. So UV goes to the first color, noise texture basically right here goes to the second color, and this give results of some kind of noisy effect on this fucking grass, if that makes sense. I hope you get it. I have this kind of scale. You can change this to 2D, 4D, whatever. Play around with the shit, okay? I'm gonna change this to 2D. You can crop the detail up. So I have this kind of values, like you can see. And basically, just add mapping, yes? And this mix RGB goes to the mapping, as you can see. Now, wait guys, I'm gonna move this. And mapping connect to the Voronoi texture or whatever it's called. So Shift A, Voronoi texture, connect right here, mapping to the vector, and change this to 2D, and that's it for now, okay? Next, you can connect a color ramp if you want, and this go basically, wait guys, this go basically to the displacement right here, okay, to the displacement on the height. Wait guys, I'm gonna zoom in because it's late. I see fucking shit. So this color ramp goes to the height and displacement go to the displacement right here. And second setup, just search for some image. Of course I have this kind of image, play around on the scale, on the whatever, and add mapping textures coordinate, mapping one image or whatever, and just plug this to this principal BSDF or whatever it's called, this fucking shader, I always forget. And basically another setup is right here, because I can make this grass disappear in two directions, if that makes sense, in this direction and this direction. I'm gonna show you, but first you have this principal BSDF or whatever, and just connect this to mix shader, okay? Now another notes that you're gonna need, basically you must add right here the value, okay, the value, and just add another Voronoi texture and connect this value to the scale right here, and this value connect to this fucking Voronoi texture too. So you can control the scale on this value, basically on those Voronoi textures, if that makes sense, yes? So you're connecting this mapping right here to this vector and scale the value right here on this scale and on this fucking another scale. And I can control the scale on this fucking grass if I'm gonna move, yes? Now this goes to separate X, Y, and Z, this Voronoi texture right here. And you can change this to 2D too, and you know, play around if you want. Separate X, Y, and Z, okay, right here, connect, and you need three math nodes basically. So math node, math node, and math node, and basically just search for the compare right here and compare right here or whatever it's fuck my English, you get it, the idea, just search for this, okay? Compare, yes. And X goes right here and Y goes right here. And on this fucking math nodes, I can make it disappear, if that makes sense. I'm gonna show you. If my PC is not gonna log in. Wait, guys. Right here, as you can see. Oh no, the grass is fucking disappearing. Let's go, as you can see. Yes. And I feel like I must build more to this to add some kind of ground, if that makes sense. Yes. And connect this shit to the ground to make it. Yeah, I can, you know, make the grass in random places. But whatever. This is just a first setup. So X, Y, and Z, compare, compare, matter notes, yes. And right here, you must change, connect those two compares to another mat node. Right here, to minimum. So those two mat nodes goes right here to this minimum. And this goes basically to the factor on this mix shader. And that we connect in this principle BSDF with the texture. And another shader is like transparent, because we see this shit and don't see this shit, if that makes sense. So we get the idea, this is transparent, this is disappearing stuff, and we controlling the disappearing shit with the voice compare, if that makes sense. Yes, as you can see, we in this direction and another direction. Yes, and X, Y, and Z. I hope my PC is not lagging, and you see the results. And you can change, of course, on this displacement the height, because you're gonna have this big kind of grass. Just change the on this displacement height, and this goes basically, this mix shader goes to this fucking surface, yes, right here or whatever, on this first one. So I hope you get it. I don't know if I have to repeat this shit once again. Watch this video once again and just speed up this video 100 times. It's gonna be watchable, and I'm not gonna repeat myself. And I feel like, as you can see, this give this kind of results. It's not that good and not that great. It's not that good and it's not that bad, if that makes sense. So yeah, thank you for watching, guys. Maybe on the next tutorial I'm gonna build this shader, because it's cool, and maybe I'm gonna build more to have control on the ground, if that makes sense. Yes, or maybe just build this. So yeah, thank you for watching, guys. Or I can show you, I'm gonna save this, and I can show you some, wait guys, grass, some stairs shader procedural. It's very simple, it's shitty, but whatever. So I'm gonna show you right here, procedural stairs, and it's very simple. Just add, once again, plane, subdivide, yes, by 100 times, and add material, displays, and bump only right here. And this is the setup. Basically, you have this texture scoring connect to the mapping, yes, right here, for the from the first one, and this goes to the vector mat scale, and this goes to separate X, Y, and Z, and this goes basically to snap, yes. And basically this have this kind of effect, like it's making this kind of stairs. Maybe I'm gonna show you if my PC is not lagging, as you can see. And I can from the plane, yes, it's very simple. And on the scale, you're changing this stuff, and the angle, of course. I know it's shitty. And on the snap, you can change, yes, right here too, because this basically displays on this direction, because we are from the texture's coordinates from the first one, if that makes sense. I hope you get it. So this goes to snap, yes, separate, and X, Y, and Z to snap to mat node. Mat node, I have this kind of value, right, as you can see. And this goes to smooth min maximum, and on the smooth maximum, you can play around too on this stuff. So basically, you have this kind of like one and stairs, yes, and you can play around with this shit. It's very simple. And this goes to the displacement, and displacement to the displacement. So textures, mapping, vector mat scale, separate, X, Y, Z, mat node snap, and mat node smooth maximum. And you have this kind of stairs effect. I hope my PC is not lagging, because I show you the render and it's always lagging. So sorry for that. Thank you for watching. Build those if you want. Maybe I'm gonna build more in the next tutorial on this grass shit. See you on the next video, guys.